people, and welcome back to my channel. So today, like any other car video, what do I have to do? I have to get Starbucks. I actually have a gift card that I have to use, or don't have to use, but I want to use, from my friend. And so we're gonna go get some coffee, and then we're gonna talk about all things TMI, all right? We're gonna talk about all things girl related, period related, sex related, all things that you'd probably want to ask your older sister. So let's go. I have literally no idea what I'm getting, and I'm driving up to the window right now. Okay, cool. Love that for me. Okay, I think I'm gonna do a grande iced chai tea latte. And then can I do the sweet cream cold foam on top? Okay, so I got a grande chai tea latte iced with the sweet cream cold foam on top. And I know, trust me. There's many healthier things that I could have gotten than that. But guess what? I didn't, because I wanted a chai tea latte, and so that's what I got. Cause you were so excited for me to finally drive up to your house. She's everything I'm insecure about, but today I drove through the suburbs. Guys, I am so obsessed with that song right now. I'm sure literally the entire population right now is obsessed with that song, but I'm just telling you, I've just listened to that song the entire drive here, and I probably listened to it on repeat like 3 or 4 times, so that's great. Like I said, I got a chai latte iced with the sweet cream cold foam, and it's legit the best, like, treat yourself drink ever. I think it's better than like any frappuccino or anything like that. It's literally the best, so if you have not tried this yet, please try it. Actually, the best drink ever is like when it's fall and you can get the pumpkin flavoring, like the syrup in the sweet cream cold foam. It's so good. Anyways, let's just get into the point of this video, which is a TMI question Q&A thing. I'm so excited for this. I wrote down your guys' questions, so we're like really official and fancy, even though it's like not fancy. But basically, I asked you guys on Instagram to send in any juicy questions, like TMI, like girl chat questions, and I wanted to answer them for you guys because I always like have a huge desire to just be real with you guys on here, and so that's what I want to do. And I know a lot of you guys are girls, and most, I think it's like 98.9% of my viewers are all female, so obviously that makes sense. But I do want to preface this and say, if you are not like a little older, I would not watch this. And if you're not a female, I probably wouldn't watch this. I'm definitely going to be a very honest and very real about some things. And so if you guys do not want to hear some juicy real life girly things and like adult things, then don't watch this video. But I'm really excited, and like I hope that I can just be a big sister to some of you guys. I never had a big sister or anything like that. I was always really close with my mom. But if you guys just need any advice and stuff like that, I always long to be able to give that to you guys. And so that's basically what I want this video to be. I just ask you guys to ask me some questions so that I can just be able to help you guys. So I wrote down some of my favorite questions that you guys asked, and I'm going to go ahead and answer them right now. The first question is an embarrassing period story. And you guys, my story is so embarrassing. I feel like it's just like weird. Like, I feel like it's just like, it's just weird. If you went to my high school, don't watch this. But anyways, so basically I was in probably my freshman year, maybe like middle school. And it was like, I wasn't like totally like comfortable with my period yet. Obviously, like, you're younger, you're kind of more like immature about it. And I was just like, was really shy about it. And so I remember one time we had chapels every single Wednesday. So like we would go to chapel in the morning or the afternoon or whenever it was. And we'd all sit in the auditorium together and just like have worship. And then we'd have like a service or something. And I remember this one time I was sitting there and we were in chapel, and I knew that I had started my period. And so we were sitting in the seats, and I like was so scared to get up, but they were the kind of seats that like you sat down and like they fold back up after you stand up. So like luckily if there was anything on the seat, like no one would see it, because I just like stand up really quick and no one would see it. And I was wearing black pants, so like I was pretty okay. But I just remember like I knew that I bled through, and I knew that it definitely got on the chair. And yeah, it was just really embarrassing. And so then I just like left it there. So I like got up and I left it there, and I just remember I was just so nervous and I was so shy and scared, and so I didn't do anything. But yeah, kind of embarrassing. The next one is so hard for me to answer because everyone has very like opinionated beliefs on this and views on this, and I'm not going to tell you guys what you guys should do. I'm not here to tell you guys what I believe that is right and wrong. I'm not going to tell you guys like that you guys are wrong if you do it one way or the other. I'm just simply going to answer the question for myself, and that's about birth control. And so I just really don't want anyone to like take this as like professional medical advice or anything like that. I'm just going to tell you guys my personal conviction, my personal like stories and stuff. So I grew up a virgin my entire life, and I saved myself for marriage because that was what I believed was biblical. And so I saved myself for marriage all the way until my wedding night, and I had never been on birth control or anything like that my entire life because I didn't have bad periods, I didn't have anything like that. And so I started taking birth control like a week or 2 or 3 weeks before my wedding, and I hated it. I took it for a while and it was okay for the first couple weeks, but then like I was just not myself. Like my hormones were just out of whack. Like I was just moody and I was just not myself at all. And I know some people love birth control. Like I know some people swear by it and it helps them with periods like a lot. Like I know it helps with like really bad cramping, I'm pretty sure. And I know a lot of people have like really, really bad periods, and like birth control can really help with that. But I never had that happen to myself. And so I can't speak from that experience for myself. I always had like pretty regular, okay periods. And so I never had to experience anything like that. So I'm not like shaming anyone if you are using birth control. I'm just saying that for me, it was just not the solution for me. And so I think like around our wedding night, like I stopped taking it just because Psyche and I both, my husband and I, we both decided that that was the best decision for us and that I just needed to stop. And so I don't take any form of like the pill birth control as far as like sex and stuff and contraception and kind of like preventing children. I will tell you guys our personal view, my personal view, my personal conviction. Again, do not take this as like a right and wrong thing. Everyone has their own conviction, and like I know there's certain health reasons too, like where you need to do a different way. But right now, again, if you're young, don't watch this, and if you are like my family member, don't watch this either, because it's just gonna be awkward. But this is just real life stuff, guys, and I want to be real because like I just hate like putting on a front that's just like not real. And so but right now, so like we've been using like condoms and stuff just because right now we don't feel we're in the place to have a child. However, I will say that we have felt this kind of personal conviction. I talked a little about this on my podcast actually, so if you guys want to hear more about this talk, go look at my podcast. I'll leave it in the description box below. But we feel a personal conviction to not like completely take out the Lord from this. And so what I mean when I say that is that I feel like if I am constantly using contraception and different kinds of forms of like child prevention, I'm completely taking out like God's control over my life, like out of like childbearing, if that makes sense. In a sense, it's almost saying that my agenda, my plan for my life is better than what God's plan is for my life. And this was just like a more recent conviction that we're still kind of walking through, kind of like figuring out together. But we don't like the idea that like we're doing every single thing we can so like God's like God can't give us a child right now. You know, like we know that if God's gonna give us a child right now, He's gonna make a way for it. He's gonna provide for us. He's going to do all these things. And so this is just me being very honest, very real with you guys. I haven't even really talked to my friends about this, but how we've looked into the family like planning thing, which is like the fertility awareness method. I can never say that. Which is basically like taking your basal temperature every single day and just like tracking your cycle and like your ovulation, your period, all that stuff. And it's actually been working really, really great for us, and we've loved that. So that's what we've done. I will recommend this book. I'll put it right here. I think it's called Taking Charge of Your Fertility. I'll put it right here. And I'll also link it down below. And it's been really, really good and really, really educational for me, because I feel like in our society and like in our education systems, like we don't learn about that stuff. Like I didn't learn about all this stuff about my body until recently, and I'm 20 years old. You know, it's just crazy to think that I never knew so many of these things from like school and stuff. Like I feel like that's something that they need to teach you anyways. But long story short, that is pretty much my belief on like that for my own life. Again, do not take that as like an answer to your problems or anything like that. I'm just trying to tell you my personal conviction, and maybe it can help somebody out there, and maybe it'll help you realize things that you want to do for yourself. Again, I'm not shaming anyone if you do something else. Totally, totally fine. I know everyone has personal convictions, and that one's just one of mine. The next question is another one that's very TMI, but like I said, why are you gonna watch this video if you don't really wanna know? TMI. It's literally just about being too much information. So just getting real juicy and real up in here. But does sex hurt? And that's something that I was, like, so scared about, because, like I said, I was a virgin until my wedding night, and I was, like, always brought up with the belief that, like, sex hurts, it's painful, it's not even great, like, all this stuff, it's awful, you'll, like, bleed everywhere. Like, I just, like, had all these thoughts, and that's what I thought for, like, literally, like, my whole life. And I'm not gonna lie, it's definitely not painful. Like, it's not comfortable, it's not like easy when you first have sex for the first time, but it's not like a painful, like, it's not like, for me at least, I know a lot of people have different experiences, but for me it wasn't like painful, like I felt like I was getting stabbed or something, but it was just uncomfortable, you know. It's like a part of your body that's like never been like used before, and like for that way. And so that's what I would say, is that it, I know it's a different experience for everyone. A lot of my friends say that, like, when they got married, like, it hurt really, really bad and for a long time. But I'll say for me, from my experience, it wasn't, like, awfully painful. It was just kind of, like, uncomfortable. And it was just kind of, like, it took a lot to get used to. Like, it still does hurt a little bit, like, every so often. But, like, it's just because your body has, like, different, like, times. And, like, your body just goes through so much when it's getting used to this whole new, like, thing that you're putting into your life. And so, that's what I would say. I hope that made sense. I hope this whole video is making sense, because I feel like it's so hard for me to make sense. I don't know. Cheers. And kind of going along with, does sex hurt? This one says, is the first time weird? And Psyche and I actually touched on this already too. We did a video talking about, like, was waiting for marriage worth it and all that stuff. And from our experience, no, it wasn't weird at all. I mean, maybe it was a little bit like we were nervous because there was just so much buildup for it. Like, we literally had been waiting our entire lives for that one moment. But it wasn't weird. It wasn't uncomfortable, like awkward or anything like that. It was just so like natural. Like, it just felt so natural to be in that state, in that vulnerable state with him. And when it's with the person that you truly love, that you're truly meant to be with, like you're meant to be vulnerable with them. Like, all my walls were down. Like, I was just ready, and I was just comfortable with him, and I was just, yeah, I was just comfortable with him. And so that's what I would say. It wasn't weird. It was a new experience, but it wasn't weird. It wasn't like awkward or anything. Someone says, do guys think periods are gross? And this is an interesting question, because I feel like everyone thinks that, and to an extent I think it's true. I mean, I think I even think that periods are gross. Like, I just hate, like, the thought of, like, blood. I don't know, I hate periods and they're gross. But I think for guys, it's not necessarily that they're grossed out. I think they just don't know a ton about periods. Like, they're like, oh my gosh, you're bleeding, like, for an entire week, like, what's going on? I think it's just weird. But I don't think they're grossed out by it. If anything, maybe if they, like, literally saw, like, blood or something, they'd probably, like, be really grossed out. But the thought of a period and, like, talking about periods, like, I mean, my husband is not grossed out about it. I'm sure there are some guys who are, like, really grossed out about it, but for the most part, like, don't be with a guy that's gonna be, like, shameful or, like, talk about your period as being gross, because a period is literally, like, meaning that you are able to, like, give life, you know? Like, a period's healthy. Like, that's a good thing that you should be able to have. And so guys should not be, like, shaming you or making you feel disgusting for having a period when it's such a good thing. Okay, a couple of different people asked me this, and I thought it was so funny because I can completely relate to this question. And they said, tips for being confident in the bedroom when you're married. And just, like, how do you be confident when you're married, like, in bed, like, in sex and stuff. And that is such a funny question, but it's just honestly so real. I was definitely nervous. Like I said, I was nervous because there was so much buildup. I was nervous that it was going to be awkward. Now in hindsight, I know it wasn't as awkward as I thought it was going to be, but I was definitely, like, not confident. And I still, I mean, it's like weird because it's just a whole new world. But just knowing that you are with the person that God picked out for you to be with, you know, like, you're gonna spend the rest of your life with this person. They're gonna see you grow in so many different ways. They're gonna see the worst of you and the best of you, and they're gonna see you, like, literally, like, physically at your worst and, like, spiritually and mentally at your worst. And they're also gonna see you at your best. And so when someone knows you that well and they just know every single part of you, it's so easy to be confident because you just know that you're doing it right. You just know you're with the right person, you know. That's what I'd say. If you are confident that you're with the right person, I think it's going to be easy for you to be confident in bed. I think, like, that just sounds so weird, but I just think it's true. And I think when you are confident that, like, your relationship is, this is the one that you are supposed to be through your whole life. And like I said, I believe that you're supposed to wait until you get married to have sex. And so once you are married to that person, like, It is so easy. Like, you don't even need to have, like, confidence in the bed. It's just something that's natural. I think it's not as, like, there's not as much pressure on, like, performing or something. Like, when it's the person that you're meant to be with, you're not gonna have to, like, perform in bed. Like, you're not gonna have to, like, do all these, like, things in order to make it perfect. Like, it's going to be great because of what you're doing and because of what it means and because of who you're with. And so, I think that's how I would tell you guys to be confident. I don't think it really takes, like, confidence in performance as much as it does, like, confidence in your relationship with this person, and that, like, they're gonna love you at your worst, not your best. The next question is, what period products do you use? And this is actually so funny, and I do not tell many people about this, so I'm about to tell the whole internet, but it's fine, whatever. I have never used a tampon. Is that weird? I don't know if that's weird. But yes, I have never used a tampon in my life. I've always grown up using pads. I've never used a tampon, anything like that. I was just always, like, super weirded out by them, and they kind of, like, scare me and creep me out a bit. And you're just, like, I don't like the idea of, like, putting something inside of me and, like, leaving it in there, like, all day. I don't know. That just, like, grosses me out and, like, makes me lightheaded just thinking about it. And so, I personally never use them. That's what most people use. I know it's, like, the best for most people, but simply, I just cannot do it. I cannot bring myself to do it. Maybe someday I will, like, after I have a child, maybe, but no, just, it literally makes me want to throw up just thinking about it. And the next one says, how are you doing family planning? And that's kind of what I talked about in, like, the birth control section was, we're trying the FAM, method, and it's, like, the fertility awareness method. And basically what it is, like, you're tracking your cycle. So I use this app called Natural Cycles, and I, like, paid a subscription. I also got, like, the thermometer that you have to buy, like, with it. And basically what it is, you're tracking your cycle, you're tracking, like, your ovulation, and you are, like, strategic every single day. In the morning before you get out of bed, you take your temperature. I don't want to, like, teach you guys about it, like, so read the book that I recommended, because it's really good, because I will not explain it justice at all. But I take my temperature in the morning, and, like, basically around your ovulation, like, your temperature will spike, and then, like, it'll slowly go down. So, like, usually, like, your ovulation, like, the day that you ovulate, it's, like, the highest temperature, and then it'll go down, then you'll, like, then that's when you'll start your period. And you're not, like, fertile. Like, you're not able to get pregnant all the day, like, all the days of your cycle. Like, that's just not true. You're normally only able to get pregnant, like, 6 days, I think it is, out of your entire cycle. And so, basically, it's kind of a more natural way to family plan is by, like, tracking your cycle. And so that, it's a really, really good way of preventing pregnancies, as well as planning a pregnancy. If you're planning to have a baby, it's really, really good to track it, because they tell you, like, when you should, like be active, because, like, you have certain, like, areas where it's, like, you're more likely to get pregnant. So, but there's also times when, like, you're not likely to get pregnant, like, at all. So, like, you don't have to use as much protection. So that's what I use. It's called Natural Cycles is the app that I use specifically. There's a ton out there. So just do your research and look up, like, the FAM method, because it's really, really good. And like I said, the Taking Charge of Fertility book is really good too. 25-year-old, never dated anyone, advice. And all I can say to you is that, like, one, like, I feel you. I did not date anyone until my husband, and that was at 19, and now I'm married at 20. And it's crazy. I know, like, you're 25, so you're definitely older than me, but I feel like we can still relate in the sense of, like, you've never dated anyone. Like, I literally did not date anyone my entire life, and for me, it was so hard because I felt like that was the definition of me, and that meant that, like, I was not good enough for a guy. Like, what's wrong with me? Like, well, there must be something wrong with me. Like, obviously I can't get a guy. But I would just say to you, like, know that, like, God has someone in mind for you. Like, do not, like, feel the pressure to have to, like, do all this stuff in order to find the one, you know, or find your soulmate. You know, that's not even a thing, you know. Just be confident and stay firm in the fact that, like, God has someone picked out for you. God has someone planned for you. And just knowing that, like, it's all so perfect in his timing, you know. Like, if someone told me literally a year ago that I was gonna be married today, like, I would laugh so hard. I would never have believed them. And that's because everything worked out perfectly in God's timing. Like, I did not have to do anything. Like, it wasn't out of my own power, my own, like, will, but it was, like, all in the will of the Lord. Like, it was all controlled by God. I could not have controlled any of it. He perfectly, like, laid it out, and, like, it was all just, like, falling into place. And so I would just, like, tell you, like, embrace your season of singleness, you know, like get deeper in your relationship with the Lord, like grow with him and like build yourself up as like a future wife, you know, just become the wife that you want to be to your husband someday. And don't feel this pressure to constantly be on the lookout and like look for people and look for relationships, because the Lord will bring you the person in the right time, in the right place. And we normally don't even have to do anything. It just usually just like happens, you know, it's crazy. And it's, God is just so good. Anyways, that's all the questions that I'm going to answer today, because that was a lot of time already. I think I've been filming for like 25 minutes, but I just want to tell you guys, I'm so thankful that I have this platform to just like be able to be like a big sister or a friend to you guys, and to just give you guys advice and my own stories, my own like embarrassing stories and just a, like experience and stuff. And I just love that we're able to just like sit here and talk as friends and just be real with each other, because that's literally why I want my YouTube channel to be a thing, is because I just want to be friends with you guys. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed this kind of video, let me know in the comments down below and like this video so that I know to make more of them, because I truly love talking about these things, because it's like, it's just so real, you know. This is just real life, this is just real stuff. And I hate like sugarcoating things, because this is just real stuff, you know. Sometimes you bleed on your chairs in high school and you leave it there and it's just really embarrassing. And that's just real life. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys more than you will ever know. And I'm just really, really thankful for you. And I'm just really excited to see what this year holds. Anyways, I love you guys so much, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace out, y'all.